Hello and welcome to Kinder Canteen. I'm Dr. Sveta Bajaj, your lactation expert for today. Let's talk about Kinder Canteen first. Kinder Canteen is a Facebook page which helps to educate mothers, would-be mothers and new mothers on the misconceptions in India regarding parenting. It is a very helpful page which is clearing all doubts of mothers and promoting breastfeeding and healthy eating options for kids. Let's talk about the topic of the day, that is, how can you come back to breastfeeding even if you have started formula feeding for your baby? Congratulations for being a mother. Let's start with breastfeeding first. What is breastfeeding? We all know that according to WHO, we must breastfeed our child for at least 2 years of age and exclusive breastfeeding for till 6 months of age. So let's start. As soon as you conceive and you have selected your birthing center, make sure you, your partner and your birthing expert together are in the contribution and evaluation to provide colostrum, the first living liquid goal, to the baby. It can even be done whether irrespective of the type of delivery the baby has gone through. Even if it is a C-sec delivery or a normal vaginal delivery, the baby can get the living liquid goal known as colostrum. Now, what is colostrum and why is it important? Colostrum is the initial few liquid drops which come soon after the delivery of the child. It is the immunity giver to the child. It smells just like amniotic fluid. It is little sticky and there are only few drops which come. Now, why it is important? It is important because colostrum coats and in the baby's intestinal layer and increases their fighting ability to the diseases. It helps, it is easier to digest. The baby feels more attached with the mother because the smell and taste is similar as just like the amniotic fluid. It gives more strength to the baby. And now, why should you feed more colostrum, or how you must make sure that the baby gets colostrum even if you are a C-sec mom? You and your birthing partner together can make sure that the few drops are pumped or hand expressed and given to the baby even if the baby is in the NICU. Now, breastfeed till how much? You must breastfeed exclusively for 6 months. Now, some people have a doubt that how can these few drops fulfill the baby's tummy. So I like to show you that in initial few days the baby's tummy is too tiny and it can be easily filled with the few drops of colostrum. So see here, the baby's tummy in the initial day one is just the size of a cherry, a size of a walnut in day three, a size of a apricot in day 7 and size of an egg on 30 days. So now you should not have any doubt. Trust your body that the baby's tiny tummy will be filled with the colostrums given to him soon as after birth. It is easy to digest, so it will easily fill the tummy and easily the baby will pass urine and poop. It will be able to clear the meconium, the black colored potty thing which the baby does in initial few days. It will be cleared easily with the help of breast milk. The colostrum is increasing the baby's ability to fight the allergies. Breast milk is increasing the baby's immunity. There are interferons, interleukins. It is a living liquid. Why it is called a living liquid? Because it is tailor-made for your child. It is not a formula packet which is same for every baby in the country. So the breast milk is changing according to the age, according to the sex, and according to the demand of the feed of the baby. And why we tell that you should feed from one side completely and then from the other side, that is because first the hind milk, the fore milk comes, which is for the thirst for the baby. The thirst which the baby feels, it is more watery, more liquidy. It is for the thirst of the baby. And after some time, the fore milk starts to come, which is for the hunger portion of the baby. So in the initial few days after delivery, you should follow a thumb rule, that is to breastfeed the baby every 2 hourly. Why we say to breastfeed the baby 2 hourly? Soon after the birth, babies are still not aware that they are out of the womb. They are still sleepy. They don't cry and wake up so much. So it is better to wake them up every 2 hourly and feed them. By this, even the mother is getting helped. The demand and supply rule is applied. As and as you feed the baby, the more the baby is near the mother, the more the touch, the smell, these things also help to increase the supply of the milk and the milk formation in the breast. Now let's talk about breastfeeding. Breastfeeding, first thing is the position of the mother. Make sure that you yourself are comfortable, not in pain. Make sure you have a good back support, a good hand support, and somebody to help you along with your child. Now to carry the child for the breastfeeding, you must always make sure that the baby head is positioned, well positioned. Complete body of the baby should be turned towards you. The tummy of the baby should touch the tummy of the mother, and then you can easily hold your breast in a C shape with 3 fingers below to support your breast, 1 finger above to hold the nipple so that it is not touching against the baby's nose. Like this you should hold the breast and then touch that nipple along the nose and upper lip of the baby. First the baby will see and then open a wide mouth and then put the nipple and make sure the larger black portion of the breast is inside the baby's mouth so that the baby can suckle properly. Now make sure that the total baby's body position is towards you and not just the neck. If the only the neck is towards the breast and not his body, the baby's neck will get tired, he will have pain and baby will start crying. So the breastfeeding session will not be completed. Now for the nipples of the mother, usually even during pregnancy, few mothers start the nipple exercises. I advise you to avoid it so that it doesn't cause dryness. There are few types of nipples of the mothers. This is inverted, everted and flat. If the nipple is flat, you must do the nipple pulling exercises. There is a syringe exercise also which you can do for the bringing the nipples back to the normal position. And the expression with the pump also pulls the nipple out. Now, if the nipples are okay, in the initial few days, you are going to have some pain, some cracks in the nipples. For that, I advise you to apply your own breast milk on the nipple. Leave it for air drying and then you can restart with the next feeding session. After that, let's talk about the latching. For the latching, see here, this is known as a good latch. Why it is called a good latch? Because the more portion of the black areola of the breast of the mother is in the mouth of the baby, so there will be a good suckling action and good milk supply to the baby. This is known as a poor latch. Why? Because the baby is only sucking the nipple. This is going to cause more pain, more cracks and more soreness in the breast. So this is a wrong latch. Make sure the baby is getting completely latched properly. For that, you must hold the breast near the baby's eyes first, then touch it on his upper lip and nose. The baby is going to open a wide mouth around 120 degrees Celsius and then you must put the nipple inside the baby to suckle. Now the breast milk is changing according to the sex of the child, according to his demands and even according feed to feed. If the baby is more thirsty, the breast milk will be more watery. If the baby is more hungry, the breast milk is going to be more solidified so that the hunger of the child is completed. Now, why are we saying that you should not formula feed your child? Because the formula is lacking in few of the constituency. Like the formula is not tailor-made for your child. The formula is a packed content with a written content which is fixed in vitamins, minerals, and carbohydrates, which are same for everybody. But if your baby has gone through a vaccination today, the formula doesn't know that the baby is sick, is undergoing vaccination, having cough, cold or any viral infection. But your body knows. So the breast milk is giving the baby interleukins, immunity fighters, and building his brain. We all know that all kids develop and mature throughout our age. But the basic and major development portion is seen in pregnancy. Until 2 years of age, we all see the babies growing. So in these 2 years, the maximum and the foundation stone which we can give to our child is breast milk, so that the foundation is laid correctly and the baby's development, his brain, intelligence, antibodies are given in the correct portion to the baby. The formula milk, if you are feeding with a bottle, you need to make sure that every part of the bottle and the pump are sterilized. The formula packet is properly placed. And there can be nipple confusion also to the child. So if there is a, this is a vicious cycle. Once if you have started formula feeding, then the baby's demand to the mother's milk will decrease and supply from breast milk will also decrease. Because the breast milk is easy to digest, baby will take more and easily pass urine and stool. His stomach will be easy to empty and easy to fill. But if you are giving formula feed, it is very complex. It is not easy for the child to digest it completely and sooner. So the tummy of the child will remain satisfied and filled for longer duration. So if you are following the 2-hour breastfeeding routine, the baby will suckle less because his tummy is already full. So the demand will be less, the body will give you less supply accordingly. In case the baby is teething, you must, if you are breastfeeding the child, make sure by 6 months of age, baby already has started understanding the mother's patterns of talking, voice and eyes reactions. So if you say no to the baby in 2 and 3 times, the baby will understand that he doesn't have to bite when breastfeeding on the breast. You can even alternatively express, hand express or pump express your milk and freeze it in the freezer in the ice cube form and give those breast milk popsicles to the baby when he is teething, so that the baby's gum are soothed and at ease. So the baby will in a way even drink the breast milk, play with the breast milk, and even the teething will become easier for him. It is better than giving a artificial plastic toy or a pacifier. There are few issues in breastfeeding. Like if the child has got a tongue tie. If a child has got a tongue tie, nowadays it is very easy to get a tongue tie corrected. The pediatrician will evaluate and let you know about it. In case the child is developing thrush, there are white lines around the mouth, around the lips of the baby and around your own nipples. So make sure you clean the baby's tongue after breastfeeding with a small white clean cotton cloth. Now, what is the formula missing? The formula is missing on hormones. The formula is missing on antimicrobial actions. There are no digestive enzymes in the formula. The growth factors are missing. The cytokinins are missing. And the stem cells are missing in the formula. These things are not tailor-made, so the formula cannot give it to your baby. There is no protection against infections with the formulas. And it is very difficult to digest also. The allergies, nowadays there are allergies, so wheat allergy, so the patient, babies are going on gluten-free diet. By giving breast milk, even these chances of allergies are decreasing. There are few type of holes which can be easy, which can guide you how to hold the baby to while breastfeeding. See, this is known as a cradle hold. This is known as a lying down hold. This is known as a football hold and a lead back hold. So if you are having twins, in the football hold, the head of the baby is considered as the football. Make sure you grasp the head properly and you can feed the baby, both the babies equally at same time from both the sides. This is the way the football hole is going to help you. In the formula, there are estrogen components also, which in a way even hinder the sexual and reproductive parts of the baby. And there is no protection to the mother's health if the mother is formula feeding. The breastfeeding mother is protected against many more diseases like breast cancers, ovarian cancers and all. But if the formula feeding mother, she is protected, but the formula is not protecting as she is not breastfeeding. Now let's talk more about the breastfeeding. As I told you, the demand and supply rule is very important. So if you have already started formula feeding your child and now you want to come back to breastfeeding, the first and most important is to feed the baby. The more you feed, the more the milk supply will be there, because the demand and supply rule will automatically apply on your body as well. Secondly, make sure you drink lots of fluids. Fluids is very much important in making of breast milk. Thirdly, what to eat. When you are breastfeeding, you must make sure you get 500 calories more in your diet. Avoid oily food and fried food. Make sure you take lot of jeera, dalia, oats, sabudana. These things also make milk. Make sure you drink milk, coconut water and lots of fluid. Now third, let's come to the other part. How the position matters. If you are not comfortable, you won't be able to comfortably feed your child. So make sure you are well supported. You are well supported with your back, your neck and your shoulders, your arms. And now after breastfeeding, make sure you burp the child. To burp the baby, make sure after every breastfeed, you hold the child against your shoulders in an upright position for 10 to 15 minutes, and between you can gently tap the back. If you are so tired, you make sure that the other family members and the dad of the child is involved in the parenting process equally and can take part in changing the diapers and burping the baby. So the sound of burping is really not important. What is important is that the baby is at ease and is not fussy. So make sure that the baby is at ease, you can easily burp the baby in this way. Now how do you know that the baby is getting complete breastfeed or the baby is hungry? If the baby is small and the baby is wetting at least 6 to 7 pees and 2 or more poops in a day, that means the baby is getting complete feed. And the pediatrician will also tell you that the baby's weight is gaining or not gaining. Secondly, you have to trust your body. Every mother is made to breastfeed the child and every body is tailor-made to breastfeed the child. So you have to first of all trust yourself, your body and the baby so that you both are comfortable. And the breast should not just be introduced when you are feeding the baby. To increase the breast milk along with your diet, like increasing the water intake, increasing your fluid intake, you can take more oats, dalia, sabudana, khichdi. Along with these, if you are more in touch with your baby, if you are in more skin to skin with your baby, even this helps the hormones to develop and make more milk for the baby. Now what happens is, in the initial few days, the baby starts to latch from one side. Sometimes mothers observe that the other breast also starts leaking. But when the other breast also starts leaking, mothers are very much satisfied that yes, I am making so much of milk. And in few days, the other milking breast stops leaking. This gives us a doubt that I think that now I am not able to make good milk, that is why I am not leaking. But that is not a matter of doubt. Your body has adjusted to the baby's demand, and that is why the supply is also according to the baby's demand. There is no oversupply. That is why the leaking has stopped. For the mother, For decreasing the backache and the neckache, you must wear good fitted and airy clothes so that there is no problem to you yourself when you are breastfeeding the baby. Now, in breastfeeding, and let me talk about breastfeeding in public, you should not feel ashamed and shy when you are breastfeeding your baby in public. It is always healthy, handy, and the best part which breastfeeding gives you is there is no extra money which you have to spend in buying tons of formula milks and then the sterilization parts and then the lots and lots of bottles, and you have to carry so many things to formula feed your child. But if the baby is on breastfeeding, you can anywhere, anytime, by any means breastfeed the baby, because the breast milk is at the most optimum temperature. It doesn't require any sterilization, it doesn't require any products, it doesn't require any money. You and the baby, just two things are required to breastfeed the child. It can be done anytime and anywhere. Now, to conclude, in the end, I must tell you the ABC of breastfeeding. A is the awareness. Don't wait for the child to cry. The baby gives you so many signs, like the baby's eyeballs start turning here and there. The baby makes his wong wong sounds. The baby will open his big mouth and see here and there. His fist will be tight like this. These all are also indications of hunger, and cry is the ultimate indication of hunger. So be aware of it. And secondly, after few days, there are growth spurts in the body of the baby. Like around 40 days of age, around 3 months, 6 months, and then around 9 months and 1 year. At these times of growth spurts, the baby will demand of feed continuously. So that time you don't have to doubt yourself that baby is hungry, that is why he always wants milk. No, it is his baby's growing pattern. Accordingly, the baby is demanding more feed and more attachment with the mother. Secondly, let's come to the B part. You have to be patient. Breastfeeding is not an overnight job. It is a journey. It is a bond. It is a bond which is going to help the mother and the baby to increase and to develop a healthier environment and a healthier baby for tomorrow. So you have to be patient within yourself. Don't stress yourself. Even stress decreases the milk supply of the breast. So don't stress yourself. Be calm, composed, and patient with your baby. C is comfort. Make sure you and your child both are in a comfortable position to breastfeed. This journey is going to be incomplete if any one of you are in pain. So if you are not in pain, then obviously you will be able to latch properly, sit properly, and the duration of breastfeeding is going to be fantastic. So I wish you all a very successful breastfeeding journey with your little ones, and we hope that the formula people just don't stop the formula at once. If you are on formula feeding your baby, you need to decrease it gradually. For that, if you are giving one scoop, decrease it to half, then to quarter, and then gradually you can stop it. If you are giving two times, then start with stopping it one time and then two more. So gradually only you have to stop the formula. In this way, the baby will also be happy and the mother's supply will also increase accordingly. And let's talk about kinder canteen once again. Kinder canteen is helping the Indian mothers for a new generation of parenting. It is giving so many tips on parenting to new mothers so that the old thinkings of parenting are washed away from our minds. And it is even helping to create a new generation, a new life, for a healthier atmosphere for us and our babies. Thank you so much. If any questions you want to ask, you can write below. I will try to answer them as soon as possible. Thank you.